Before the original East African Community collapsed in 1977, Lake Victoria Marine Transport under the East African Railways and Harbours Corporation was operating at more than 40%. But this sector was abandoned and neglected after the collapse of the community, with now dilapidated landing sites, ferries, boats, canoes, and lack of life-saving equipment.
Transport services have remained limited, reflecting low investment in vessels and deteriorating port infrastructure, and are characterized by poor safety standards.
Later, almost all East African countries did not make any investment on their infrastructure. As a result, most of infrastructure deteriorated, and now they cannot meet the current demand.
Now, the works and transport ministers of Uganda, Tanzania, Kenya, and Rwanda have designed a strategy to revive water transport on the largest regional water body, Lake Victoria. The regional ministers meeting in Kampala say the integrated water transport strategy on Lake Victoria will reduce time and the cost of shipping cargo across the region and also improve on navigation safety.
All of us, I think, can have a testimony that our heads of state are passionately involved and passionately supportive of these programs.
The ministers also observed that the potential contribution of Lake Victoria to the regional GDP is not being harnessed.
That less than 3% of the cross-border trade in East Africa is now transported on Lake Victoria as transboundary trade.
Currently, Uganda is in advanced stages of building an inland port at Bukasa on Lake Victoria. It is expected to start operating next year with 2.4 million metric tons of cargo. And by 2040, Bukasa port is expected to be handling 9.5 million metric tons of cargo. Rwanda was represented by the High Commissioner to Uganda, Major General Frank Mugambage.
Rwanda did suggest and did offer to actually spearhead a project at Kasese. It's very close to Rwanda. So we've always offered to participate and say, how do we develop this oil jet out there so that goods can come. When they come from Kisumu, they don't have to come to Kampala, they come to Kasenselo.
Rwanda has an historical attachment to Kasenselo. It is the point at which River Kagera, which originates from Rwanda, pours into Lake Victoria. The landing site also hosts a genocide memorial, constructed in remembrance of the hundreds of bodies that washed up there during the 1994 Rwanda genocide. JJingo, NTV.